Hi everyone, this is Corruption Perception Index is out now, which is by Transparency International, and score of India or rank of India is 80th this year with a score of 41. This rank is also shared by China, Benin, Ghana and Morocco. So we have total 180 countries in this index. And India is having 80th rank. Last year it was 78. Now it is 80th. So they are scaling this from 0 to 100, with 0 being highly corrupt in nature and 100 with very clean countries. And this year more than 2/3 of the countries go below 50. That is around 43 to 44 score they are having. Most of the countries having a score of 42 to 43 range. And top countries are Denmark, New Zealand with a score of 87 out of 100. And Finland is having 86th score. And then our neighboring country, Pakistan, is having 120th rank out of 180 countries. Then bottom countries are Syria, South Sudan and Somalia. Syria is having 13 score only, and South Sudan 12, and Somalia is having 9, which is the lowest rank. Then factors that this Transparency International will be considering for making this index are: whether government leaders are held to account or go unpunished for corruption, so they will be checking whether these leaders are getting punished for their corruptive measures, or the prevalence of bribery in particular country, and how the public institutions are responding to citizens' needs. So these are the factors they will be considering while making this corruption perception index. Then the main observations by this Transparency International are: corruption is more pervasive in countries where big money can flow freely into electoral campaigns and where government listen only to the voices of wealthy or well-connected individuals. This is what Transparency International says, that is, the voice of the lower bottom people are not heard by the government. They are hearing more for the wealthy people. That is only for the electoral fund flow. Then according to the NGOs, they say that even in democracies like Australia and India, unfair and opaque political financing and anti-influence in decision making and lobbying by powerful corporate interest groups result in stagnation or declining control of corruption. So they are also in the same opinion that this political parties are having well flow of money from this powerful corporate industry. So wealthy people are having more hold on this political affairs, and they are providing enough money, which is unflow in nature, that is causing a lot of corruption in all these countries. So that's all. Thank you.